Hello, Lazzy here, and in today's video, I will show you how to increase your render distance for Minecraft Bedrock Edition using normal graphics, vibrant visuals, deferred rendering, or even ray tracing. If you are enjoying today's video or learn something new, a like is always appreciated. But before we get into it, just a warning, the more you increase your render distance, the more your game will lag and you may experience some crashes. So don't go too crazy increasing your render distance. One thing to note for this tutorial, I will be using my iOS device running the latest iOS version. If you are on an Android, I apologize. I really could not work out how to get this working. Unfortunately, Minecraft doesn't appear in my Android files. I managed to get an Android device and I can't even use it. I'm not too sure why. If you know how to increase your render distance on an Android device, please let me know in the comments below so you can help myself and everyone else out. Now for Windows, it is the same method. You just need to get into your Minecraft files. I will link my tutorial on how to find Windows files in the description below. It is an older video, but the method still works. So to do this on iOS, you do need to open up the application called Files. You will need to click onto My Device. From in here, you can see all the applications you have. Now we need to go into Minecraft. Click into Games, com.mojang, and then go into Minecraft PE. I'm surprised they still call it Minecraft PE. In here, you will see an options file. Now you need to have an application where you can edit text files. For myself, I use an application called Documents. This is a free application from the App Store. However, it is a 17 plus age restricted app. So if you're unable to download this application, you should be able to find an alternative on the App Store, which will allow you to edit text files. So you can long hold on it, click share, then you can open it into Documents or whichever application you are using to edit the text file. But for myself, if I tap onto it, it will automatically open into Documents. So once the file has been opened, all you need to do is scroll a little bit down till you see the GFX view distance. As you can see, it is set at 160. So if you would like to change the render distance, all you need to do is change this number. I will show on screen and in the description below what each chunk is equivalent to for the render distance number. So now we need to change the number. So if I backspace out and just put in like 400, we're going to get a pretty good render distance view. Now to save it, all you have to do is click on back. For myself, when I click back, it automatically has it updated in the right file. However, if you do need to save it, click on those three dots, click share, save to files. And now we just need to navigate back into that Minecraft PE folder. It should come up under your recently used. And in here, click save. It will ask if you want to replace the existing item and you want to click on replace. So that is how you change the normal render distance. Now, if you would like to change your vibrant visuals or deferred rendering render distance, you can do the same from within the same file. So all we need to do is just scroll down a little bit further until we see the option deferred underscore view distance. As you can see, it is 12. I'm not too sure why they have the different number values. So if I was to change this 12 to a 16, it changes my render distance to 16 chunks. And you can also do the same with ray tracing. As you can see just above, there is a ray tracing view distance. However, modifying these to increase the render distance, you're gonna get some lag. But I just wanted to mention that is how you increase your vibrant visuals render distance. Change the value in here and how far you want your render distance to be. But be aware, the more you increase it, the more lag and the more prone you are to crashes. Now going back into Minecraft, you can see my render distance has significantly increased. You will know it has worked if you go into settings, video settings, scroll down until you see the render distance settings. You will see your max render distance now have a plus next to it. That means it has increased your render distance and increased your lag. That just goes to show you that it has worked, but I'm sure you can tell in your world by looking outside in the distance, you will see that it is a lot further. But that is all for this short tutorial. If you did enjoy it, once again, a like is always appreciated. I shall see you in the next one, and peace.